Everybody, Gerone Wright here, and once again you're joining me on my Gerone Wright YouTube channel here on YouTube. Alright, in this video I'm going to be at some cave drawings. I believe that these cave drawings are supposed to be 25,000 years old. No, the cave system is supposed to be 25,000 years old, and I believe that the drawings themselves, they might be dated back at like 22,000 years or so ago, being preserved inside of the cave system. Alright, these cave systems, these are the, what are they then? The Perch Merle cave cabarets, and they're the Quercy region in France. Okay, and the photograph is from René Dillon Castellet. Okay, and it's 92108 Boulogne, France. Okay, this is one of the images that I used from off of line. Okay, so this is a one of the images, and but they're all pretty much the same of this cave system. Okay, with this drawing, French experts, scholars, or cave drawing artists have dubbed this as being a woolly mammoth. This here looking like horses and bisons, okay, or some type of animal, four-legged creature. Here's another one over here, all right, right there. There's his head, there's his body. It appears to be making some kind of contact with the butt area of this creature here. All right, then we have this creature here. All right, so basically what we have here is this is not no woolly mammoth. All right, I have made my fair share of discoveries of woolly mammoths in cave drawings and mountain-sized drawings and in sea stacks. This is not no woolly mammoth. This is a creature, a mutation, which is an upright, showing how man reinvented himself. This picture is showing how mankind was bridged between the creatures that I am about ready to describe. Okay, now this creature here is more reminiscent of an upright ape, and I'm going to go into detail and showing you. This would be the leg, this would be the right leg, this would be the right arm, this would be the tail region, and this would be the head in here, which is amazing because if you look at this closely, there is actually a head cut in here. Now, the reason why they call this a woolly mammoth is because the head comes around and it seems it appears to have a trunk, and the trunk comes down and come here. This is how they, and then there's a bunch of hair in here. That, and this is the reason why they arrived at calling this a woolly mammoth. However, I look at, through my paranormal experience and encounter, I look at this in a totally different way. I look at this as the right leg of a man. I look at this as the stomach area of a man, or mankind, or ape kind. I look at this as the buttock area. There's a tail. This is the back of the head area. And then you notice when you come in here, it gets dark right in this area. There's two separations here. There's multiple faces in here, people, in the darkened area. I'm going to show you in a minute. I have them highlighted. But if you just take the lightened area where the darkened area separates the light, you will see that I'm right there at a chin. Here's a chin coming around the chin, and here's the mouth area, which would be the teeth area here, going around the forehead, and this is a head right here of a creature. Look at this. Again, let's blot this area out. I'll put my finger over top of that, and that's the neck area up there of that creature. Here's the chin line right there, and here's the head of that creature. So what is this creature doing standing between these four-legged animals, which look like horses, bisons, and all of that? What is that creature doing there? And he looks like something out of a cartoon that you would actually see. Why is he standing there, and why doesn't he have no real shape to his likeness or anything? Well, people, this is a mutation. These cave drawings are drawings which are like motion pictures, but you have to know what you're looking for in order to read them. All right, again, these cave drawings have a date back of supposedly 22,000 years ago. So therefore, I mean, they would rather you believe that this is a woolly mammoth than a being being back there, because this goes against everything that science has actually led us to believe to totally exist. We're not supposed to be in here doing no genetic exchanges between these animals. But yet we are, our ancestors are. Again, I'm gonna go around the chin. I'm gonna go around the chin line. I'm gonna go around the chin, come up. Here's a mouth, there's an eye. Here's the top of the head, going around the back of the head, going in the back area, around the butt, going around the leg, okay? Down the right leg, coming back up in the front of the stomach. Here's the underarm area right here. There's the arm, and then there's the chin coming back around. There is a being in there in an upright position, and he is bridged between two animals. So what is the result of this? Now, this doesn't look like no type of an intelligent being. This looks like some type of, like a bald-headed mutation of a, I guess, of one of these creatures, pretty much. But it just looks like something that, like a cyclops, almost like you would almost like that size of like a cyclops or a giant or something of that nature. That's what this looks like. All right, but there are other faces if you look closely. I'm gonna see if I can get you in closer. Underneath the chin of that creature that I just described, or can I just, maybe I can just, that I just described, we're not there with that, okay, here, that I just described, there are black faces. I'm just going to show you some of the obvious that now that I'm going to get you to tune into. If you look in right in here, underneath the chin of this guy here that I just showed you, there are multiple faces here, all right? And I do have them drawn out, but I'm gonna go to another, I'm gonna get that to you. There's a chin, wait, hold on, because there are multiple faces. There's even a monkey's face right there too that I see morphing, all of that. But however, there is a larger face in here, and then there's smaller faces, some of which include monkeys, black kings and queens faces. I don't think that you can actually see all of them. Okay, you can probably see some of the faces as I'm describing right now. I just had my face on the larger, I had my stick on the larger face, and then I lost it. But if you look in here, there's a face there. There's a face here. There's a monkey's face here. There's a face there. And then there's smaller faces inside of a larger faces. So depending on what you're seeing, I can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 black faces in here, all describing from a monkey came these black entities, and they're wearing crowns, royalty, all in this one section right here, just this in here, in this small section. Now when you back away, they become larger faces. I can draw you two monkeys' faces and a mutation from a monkey within right here in the center, and then other beings all from that. I can draw you at least 7 faces right there out of just this little darkened area right here. Now, but it gets better. Here, down here, in what appears to be what they call this a woolly mammoth's hair, there's a black woman, a black queen. You see how this oxen or this horse, it actually looks like a horse, people. I'm gonna call it a horse. In the ass of the horse, the hair is the hair of a black queen. There's her chin, there's her mouth, there's her face, and there is her crown right there. But it gets better, because this crown actually dubs as the beard of a queen, of a king that is up here. So you have a king and a queen figure. The queen figure is down here at the ass of this creature. In the ass of this creature, there's a face of a black woman. I don't care what image that you Google of this cave system, you will find it. I'm gonna have a slide video of these going on, so you'll be able to see it more clear as well too. But it is showing, here's another face right here that I'm seeing right there. Now that I'm up on this now. However, I want to get into this. I'm going to show you what's going on with this, people. The red part is the woman's mouth, and then everything else comes from that. Can you see that right there? All right, I don't know what you're seeing until this video stops. But I'm going to show you something on some of my other highlights. I'm going to show you the king's face, because in these smaller faces that are in here, there's monkeys and everything else in there. There's a king's face, and this is his crown right here. Watch this, people. Let me see where I'm at here, which picture I'm actually going to go into. All right, there's a black woman on a close-up right there. I don't know if you can actually see her. She's right here. This is giving me a lot of glare back here. Here's her crown right there. There's that figure right here. All right, here's all of those images, those little faces that I was telling you about in that, okay? Now, what they are describing as the elephant's trunk, are they elephants, are that woolly mammoth's trunk? If you notice that this cuts into like the beak of like a duck-billed dinosaur right there, you know what this is describing? That this is not no elephant's trunk, people. This is a mouth, an open mouth, which has the opposite end of a dick in it, meaning that the balls part is in this creature's mouth, and the dick, which is consistent with that of a horse, is coming snaking around. It has all of the features of the horse's penis, and it has a face on the end. There's also something else about this. It's because in that ape creature, or that creature's right leg down back over here, is the image of a reptile that I have drawn out right here. And it has a star on the side of it, actually indicating a specific type of creature, almost looking like one of those Komodo dragons right there. There's the nostril, there's the mouth, there's the eye. Again, I'm going to have to make a slide video to do a follow-up so everybody can catch on to this, because I don't know what you're getting off this screen. All right, but I have some other pictures. Let me keep going. Oh, hold on. Let me go back to this for a minute. Because where I told you that that's describing as a dick. All right, there's also a face here. It tells what kind of genes is going into this ape creature's mouth and what's being created and what's being changed. That's why all of these little faces are describing. This people is a cis. This is something that was created by a ancient royal black family that is not even mentioned in our history, and they're listed in here. And can this, all of this information can be extracted from out of this cave drawing that I can read. It's showing black royalty here, and it's showing what kind of genes that they use to genetically alter themselves between these creatures, and this is why this is being described. All right, now here, there's a chin, there's a mouth, there's a cheekbone, there's an eye, and there's a crown. That duck-billed, this ape has a duck-billed dinosaur's mouth that is open with these dicking balls in its mouth. It's also dubs as, the beak of this creature also dubs as upside-down crown for a queen, which is here. There's her mouth, there's her nose, there's her cheek, and there's her eye right in there. I don't know if you can see that, okay? All right, now, I'm going to keep going. Oh, by the way, on what I'm describing, what they call the trunk of the woolly mammoth, and I'm calling the dick of a horse, there also seems to be some type of legible text right here over top of each other, right in this area right in here. All right, so we got to look for that as well, too. Again, this is a French cave, which experts have dubbed this as something totally opposite of what it is actually is. Now here, I have the duck bill drawn in to show you. Now on face, this is far from a woolly mammoth. They got this as being a woolly mammoth based on this body. There's the trunk, and this, I guess this little, this will be the little bit of fur or whatever. But check this out. Once you just go and trace around the darkened spots, put that eye there, which is already there, just highlight, accent the eye. You see that little duck bill? I call this a duck bill dinosaur because it has the front part, because it has the slot in the nose that duck bill dinosaurs or ducks have. That's why I'm calling it a duck bill dinosaur. However, now I'm going to tell you why we know that this is an ape. Because what this is doing, people, is it is describing what the genes from this bridging with this ape, with these horse creatures, which is describing the ancient genetics of the duck-billed dinosaur, which horses derive from, it is telling you that the balls, the dick, this is the dick, it even had the sleeve, it had the foreskin, everything is there, the tip of the head, and even has a face on it, describing genes that went in and genes that came out. What it is describing, that through the semen, through the penile gland of that creature, of these, the creatures that are on either side, which are horses, which derive from ancient dinosaurs, ancient duck-billed dinosaurs, that this creature here, this ape creature, was altered. And it's showing you on this front that this ape became that of a mutation of that of the duck-billed dinosaur, showing you and describing in picture form that this creature was genetically changed by the genes of the ancient dinosaur, which is through that of the horse, and they're talking about through the penile gland, and that's why this penis is actually there. This is why there is a big mistake about them talking about this being, and this is where I got them, where they're talking about this being the trunk of an elephant. It is actually the penis of a creature, a horse, a duck-billed dinosaur horse, and it's showing you the reverse end in the mouth of that creature, telling you that this creature took those genes in and it genetically altered that creature into what the creature that the dick that it has in its mouth, it changed it into a duck-billed dinosaur. That's what it's telling you genetically. On the back of this creature here, the duck, the face, which actually is almost still like a monkey. If you look at it, this is all the shape of a monkey right there, except that it is a little bit elongated and it has the monkey looking like a duck-billed dinosaur in the face, because the duck-billed dinosaur is what genetically altered. They're telling you that the monkey's face was cleaned away, swiped away, and genetically it was altered, and it's showing you through the penile gland that this creature took on a new genetic path, and that was that of the duck-billed dinosaur. Now check this out. On the back of that, because this face is twofold. Remember I told you there's like seven faces in here? Well, enlarged, besides that face there, look at this face right here on the back of it right there. Chin, mouth, nose, eye. Almost half like a crown. There's a woman there. I call her, dub her as the being, the mother of creation. She appears in all of these drawings. Okay, for a reason that I have yet to discuss. However, I know the reason why, okay? But I'll go into details about that later on how this is all going, these designs. But people, what's happening? I gotta take you to the Black King. We gotta go forward now. All right, people, what they're calling the trunk of a woolly mammoth, I'm calling the dick of a horse, duck-billed dinosaur, which this creature evolved from, that creature's balls, his penis is extended out of there, insinuating that this creature was given the DNA from that creature, which genetically altered this beast right here, which is not a woolly mammoth, however, but it's like an ape creature as we described. There's also something else that I want to draw your attention to. You see this spike right here? Right at the creature's underarm, right there? You see that spike? There's a spike with two lines going up. At the end, people, if you look at that, if you Google this, and then if you enlarge it, I challenge you to Google and enlarge it, this spike right here. At the tip of that, what is there is a king's head, his chin, his mouth, his nose, and he has a crown on at the tip. It's like a pyramid right there, and it has a king's head on it. It's so small and minute, you can barely see it. But if you Google the image and enlarge it to whatever size you can, you would notice that it has a crown on the top of his head, and it is actually a face, which is right there. Again, talking about royal intervention, but this is, in this case, it actually was black royal intervention. Now, I got to get you to that woman again, and because there's also some other interesting stuff that I want to share with this with you. I might have to put some more in writing. All right, we shared this one with you. You can hardly see anything there. Okay, here, I'll go, oh, hold on, I just went away. Let me go right here to this image. Again, notice right here, people, at the base, at the tip, what they're calling the woolly mammoth's trunk right down here. Notice that it has the sleeve on it, that it has the foreskin. There's a head right in there with a mouth on it. The slit. It has eyes and it has nose. This has a head on it. a face, rather. And then it has the slit. The same way horses' penises come out and extend. This here, the same thing, the way horses' penises extend. But check this out when we come up here. When you get right here, there's a lump in this thing right here. Just before you get to what I'm describing as the mouth open right there. There's a black face. There's a chin. There's lips. People, when I tell you that there's this definitive features of a black face. You got the under chin there. You got the cheekbones. You got the cheek line going around the mouth. You got the lips hung out. You got the top lip. I can describe this person to a T. It looks so real that you have to. I mean, it's just amazing that it's so real. Now check this out. There's the eye slit. There's the nose. This face is so amazing that I'm just surprised. I guess, well, I know why it was missed. For experts that actually know it's there, they wouldn't tell you that it's there. But for people, you're blinded thinking that it's a woolly mammoth. You're probably saying, well, damn, this is an odd woolly mammoth. But look, people, there's the chin, there's the lips, there's the nose, there's the eye, there's the face of a black queen, again, royalty, and this duck-billed dinosaur's mouth, which is detaching that of this ape creature, is open upside down, creates her crown. So this whole thing right here is a woman. Her nose, her eye, her mouth open, everything open there. And look, on the other end of this penis, now this penis will be sliced, check this out. On the other end of this, here's her neck, begins here. So this thing is in several halves. This what they're calling the woolly mammoth's trunk. It has a woman's neck coming out of this end. There is no way that this could have been no woolly mammoth's trunk. Check this out, people. There is a neck that goes to a chin. It sticks out. There's the under chin. There's a chin. There's a mouth. There's a face here. And then the other side, there's a crown right there. There's the points of the crown right there. Look. One, two, three, and look at this thing comes down, the symmetry in this that creates a custom crown, which dubs, if it's turned the other way, the bill of this creature, which was changed, which is the ape, and is showing you all of the creatures in here which were affected by this genetic mutated change. A penis. This ain't no elephant trunk. This is a penis. Again, there's the foreskin right there. There's the head part there with a face on it. Not no nostrils, with a face. A legible face. Eyes, nose, and a mouth. Again, representing genes, genetics. And then when you come up to this end, if you look at this line crossing across here, there's a face in here. A black person's face right in there. A black woman's face. One of about 8 or 9 faces that are all black, black royalty, which is in this thing. So what is that telling you? An ape, all black royalty in here, and you have horses off to either end, and I'm talking about genetic manipulation. People, what this is describing, it is describing how blacks had an intelligent knowledge and knew how to genetically alter themselves to turn themselves into every culture group in our world today. To Egyptians, to Asians, to everything, to Caucasians. These people were the first people in our world to actually take and have this type of intelligence. And the reason why their intelligence was erased, removed from history, is because this would be devastating for Caucasians of today, and for religion of today, and for royalty of today, because they would not be able to rule and govern over us in the way that they did if you knew that you evolved to who you are today under the intelligent design of ancient blacks, which created us. I'm specifically saying, people, that ancient rooted religion, kings and queens today, the protected bloodlines of ancient rooted religion today, and the protected lines of ancient royalty and ancient religion, these people are all black. They are blacks which designed themselves to become white. But hold it though, it gets better. Because before we were black, we were reptiles, we were reptilians. People, I have discovered the holy grail to who we truly are. And I don't care what kind, if it's art, any kind of art, I can describe to you through these drawings, which I can see, they are multidimensional. And the reason why these drawings are multidimensional is because our ancestors, which were later back in these days, you go back 22,000 years ago, they would have still had their reptilian sense of being, their reptilian sense of awareness. They didn't have the vision that we had today. They had a multi-layered vision, seeing things in a way that almost like flies do, the way that reptiles do, like a double vision, a triple vision, a multi-vision, that when they created artwork, they seen it and reflected it in a way where the work overlaid itself. Through my ongoing paranormal experience and encounter, when I look at these things, my eyes automatically separate the images and play them for me in a sense like it's a motion picture. And this is the reason why I may not be the best narrator to explain this to you, but I can point you in the direction of how, where it's at, why it's there, and go through my best way of describing how it actually got there. But I'm on point, people, with that. You know what I mean? I don't have the scientific analogy for it all, the way it actually happened. However, I know how it happened, and I can describe it for you, for anybody of layman, in layman sense, to understand exactly what I am actually describing to them. Notice here that I have a face highlighted for you right there. Well, that's only just one. This is a face looking at you. And if you notice that in that face, there's some type of organ coming over off across the nose of that face. Well, people, there's another face here. Chin, mouth, nose, eye, head, and it has a queen's crown on it right there. I wish I had something to cover this over. If you cover this over from here over, there's another face right there, right here. Chin, mouth, nose, eye, and then it has a crown right there. See it? Facing out that way. Again, chin, mouth, nose, eye, and going over that way. Then there's a face in the middle. Then there's another face going over this way. These are multidimensional faces, people. And it's crazy because in the biblical days and all these angels, they talk about creatures with four and five heads. On our queen of spades or king of spades, I mean, on our kings and queens on cards, how they had the kings have two heads. Well, these creatures here have more than that. Many different heads. And then you go back to the times of Vishnu, the five faces of Vishnu, the Hindu god. Well, again, this is similar to that, except I counted out to you, I think, eight and still going here. And if you look closely, you can now see that this is almost becomes like a monkey coming, being pulled out of this creature, of a body. Look how this creature here in the center resembles that of a monkey, and the arm, which they call, I mean, this thing here, which they call the trunk, now suddenly looks like a monkey leaning forward, and this is a monkey's arm coming out, stepping away out of the body, showing that a monkey's genes is being extracted out, and it's showing you how and why the monkey's genes is being pulled out of its own body. People, what it is showing you is an abduction of a creature, showing you that a creature is being pulled away from it, the control, the genes of its own body, its own gene-controlling function, being pulled out of its body and being substituted because it is in an upright walking position, in the perfect position. Its body is being abducted, and other genes is being put in to actually now take over this body, and in, not just in the physical sense, but also in the inner sense. Well, actually, in the physical sense, and in the sense. Now, I'm telling you right now, people, that this is truly amazing. I find it to be fascinating, and too many things don't amaze me, but this here does. All right, I'm going to go to my next one because I still got to show you my black king that is here. Alright. Here's the picture out again. You notice in here, there's a face. There's a face of a black king right there. There's his crown. This becomes his beard. Now remember that his beard dubs as, this is the queen's crown right there. There's the queen's face down there. Alright, I'm going to show you some things. Hold on. And again, I'll make a slide video probably later this week. Where's my king? I want to show you my king. Because he's going to appear in my drawing that I highlighted. That's the queen again. There he is right there. You see how I have him highlighted? What's supposed to be the trunk now becomes the arm. Now remember before, in a different scenario, where there's the middle face, it looks like a monkey being extracted from a body. Well, in this picture here, it is showing you a change right there and what is happening with this monkey. And it's showing you that this monkey is taking on a man look. And it's showing you the crown. It's showing you a face. It's showing you an elongated beard. Okay. And again, the beard is actually created, is actually dubbed as a crown of the queen, which is her face is right in here as well. And the queen hair and face is all shown being created through this creature here too, this bison. It's showing you man between monkey and these creatures taken on this image. All in a cave drawing, a multi-dimensional image, a window into reality. A window into reality. Again, people, this is the, what is this? The Perch Merle cave cabarets, Quercy region in France. And that's what this is all about. Let me keep going back forward again. This is a raw version of this, everything that I just described. In fact, you can actually see pretty much a witch-like woman here. Here it becomes like a witch-like woman. There's her chin, her mouth, her nose, her eye. And it shows you again the crown. Okay? It's a king morphing his queen. You see the picture right there? You can see it right there. And can you see the other face down there? You can't see that there. But if you Google these images, people, now that I'm showing you what to look for and where to look, you will see them. Here I have the queen highlighted there. Okay, you can see about where it's at. Again, this is, I'm going to push this over. Again, this is what they describe as the trunk. Now, I have this highlighted. Look at how I highlighted this. This is not no woolly mammoth. Look, this is the body of a monkey. This is going over the back and the head area back in here. This is the, this is the head, this is the back area, the butt area. Okay, there's the leg, it's uprighted. And you know what kind of monkey that looks like? I forget what you call those little furry monkeys, the real furry monkey, and it's in, hang on, I forget about it. I forget what the monkey is called. But it reminds me of one of those, not a wool, not almost like, one of those monkeys that, I mean, has a full fur coat on it. And that's what this is. And this is the reason why this thing looks so big. And it looks like it could be a mammoth because it looks like it's monstering over these horses. You know what I mean? And this thing is a huge creature. But look at the face, how I have it highlighted again with the back of that face, with the black face on it. And then with that, and showing you that there is a dick and balls in this thing's mouth. And then there's the queen. I'm going to come in closer to show you. So you can actually look at the area that I have this in. So when you Google the image, the cave drawing of this, you'll be able to see. Alright? You can do cave drawing, Google cave drawing of woolly mammoth or French cave cabaret cave drawings. To get this image. But now you can see and understand this stuff for really what it is, people. Our ancestors were not crazy. And you know what gets me upset is because, you know, we give Egyptians, history gives Egyptians, and it just started happening recently. It just didn't happen in ancient history past. They didn't get the credit that they did, but only after Egyptians they started discovering on the inside of the pyramids the stuff that the people that the British didn't get there, and early on explorers, if they would have found that stuff and destroyed it, we would have never known that it even existed. Those pyramids would have been emptied out, would have been defaced, and we would have never known that it existed. The only reason why we even knew of this intelligence of the Egyptians now, and they're getting credit for it, is because these pyramids was unearthed after these invasions and or during a time where there could not be no cover-up. It could not be too obvious. But had the early on explorers would have made it there first, all of those tombs that have been unearthed and all of these treasures, we would have never known about it. It would have been destroyed. I've been buried, hidden away, been blown up, defaced. And another history would have been put on, another spin would have been put on history. But the good thing about this, people, is that those that hid this knowledge from us, this ancient knowledge that our ancestors had, do not know that our ancestors, how our ancestors created this. There's only one way that you can possibly know that this exists. This is to experience it through a genuine spiritual paranormal experience and encounter in the way that I did, and become subjected to it, not just mentally but physically, to the understanding of all of this. Through, I like to think that I have this reptilian sense of awareness, this reptilian sense of vision, that allows me to see these multidimensional images and show them to you and explain them to you in the way that I do. I have 500 plus videos here that you need to see. If you haven't seen them, you should see them. You know what I mean? They become more intense. Some of them are weaker than the others. Others are more powerful than others. You have to see them to relate to what I'm saying. And you will never start looking at art in the same way again. You will never start believing. I mean, you would start understanding, and you would start disbelieving everything that you were already taught, and then you will start believing what I'm actually stating. Now, again, Dada, before I cut myself off here, basically what I was stating, what I wanted to say, is that notice how that ancient blacks never got credit for their piece in history or having the intelligence to do things which benefited our world or benefit mankind today. Well, ancient blacks, real ancient blacks, I'm not talking about Africans. I'm talking about those before the Africans. I'm talking about real blacks, because Africans, I like to say, is not even Africans no more. Africa has been invaded for hundreds and hundreds of years. And for almost, even to today, from the beginning of time, Africa has always been, since almost the beginning of time, been preoccupied by an invading force, which have genetically been consistently contaminating that area. Genetically altering those people, where Africans are no longer not even Africans no more. Not just this can be said for Africans, but this can also be said for Egyptians. This can be said for Chinese, Japanese, and all. These invading forces and this occupancy that these people have, they have, and it's usually for 100 plus years that these occupancies take place of these invading forces. You know why? Because they're genetically altering the beings of the civilizations of people of these places that they're occupying. I'll make a video about that later. However, but ancient blacks are the cause for this. And in every depiction that I have, my latest things have been sea stacks. But even in these cave drawings, and those sea stacks, all of my latest discoveries all pay homage to ancient blacks, because it was ancient blacks that caused for the existences of these people. And it was through their genetic bridging themselves through these creatures that other civilizations of people were created. And this is why these drawings are paying homage to them. This is why you have black faces alongside of this monkey, which is almost appearing as a, can you see that real good? Almost looking like a duck-billed dinosaur. Yeah, I'm thinking you see that. Now, this is the reason why you see that. But now that I put that, look, all I did, people, I didn't deviate from the lines. All of these lines that I put here are things that are already there. They're just accented. And the reason why you can see them now, and there's other faces here that, I mean, I didn't highlight. Now, but my thing is that just putting the reality to this, now you see and say, you know what? That is not a woolly mammoth. This is an ape. And you start seeing that this is not a woolly mammoth, this is not an elephant trunk, that this is a penis. This is the way a horse's penis comes out and curves. And what it is describing is that the back end of, do we all know what's on the back? Now, if this is the head of the penis, and this thing is in this guy's mouth, we all know what is on the back end of a penis, and that's his balls. So, what is that telling you? Balls is DNA. Through the penile gland is creation. It is telling you that this creature, balls, is in this creature's nucleus is in this ape's mouth. And now it's telling you that the ape, look, it's not even ape no more, it's telling you. It's saying that through that nucleus, through those balls in that ape's mouth, through this constant genetic bridging, this creature was altered. This is what this is. It was a breakdown in this creature. Now, you probably say, well, why would they do that, Jerome? Why would they do that? Well, people, black genes, ape genes, I like to say, was a tough nut to crack. So what they did, our ancestors did, in reinventing and creating themselves. Now, this is not something that just happened in our world either, people. It's my position that this took place also on Venus and also on Mercury, and we're planet hopping from one planet to another. I'm not going to go into full detail about that. However, it's my position that this is a system that takes place, that this intelligence is with us from that traveling into our worlds through microorganisms which know how to invade one body to the next and know which bodies to attack to keep reinventing themselves to become into a creature to its largest state, and then it reverts back again to this process is pyramided up to this largest state, which in prehistoric times were our dinosaurs. First was the oceanic creatures, then on land was our dinosaurs, and then after it pyramids up to its highest point, peak, it comes back down again, back to its smallest peak, and this is where the extinction takes place. It's my position that this intelligence is within this microorganisms, and this intelligence that I'm speaking about right now is programmed into us, each and every one of us, just like your computers at home that you have, that you put all of this information into, and you can go back and get it out of. Well, this information is in us. You can get it out of you. There is some type of recognition right now as I am speaking, which is awakening you to what I'm actually describing. People, we were created artificially at the hands of our own self through microorganisms. We did not miraculously appear on this earth in the way that ancient texts, ancient religion, and it is being described. It was all a lie. It's not true. My name is Gerone Wright. I'm going to leave you with that. I may put some more in writing. I'm going to end the video there. And I might add some more drawings to this. I might make a slide video. I might not. I'm going to have a busy week this week. But I hope that you enjoyed this video. Thank you.